custom stinger transitions. They're hard to find, they're hard to make, but don't worry, because today I made one just for you. Before you panic, I will include a stinger transition in this pack that you can use directly in your broadcasting software. You won't be able to customize that specific one, but the other one will be a template for Adobe After Effects. So if you have Adobe After Effects, you can add your logo, you can change the color, you can change whatever. If you don't have Adobe After Effects, you can just use this stinger transition that is provided in the pack. On top of that, if you tweet this video, I will be picking 5 of you and I will be personally adding your logo to it, exporting it to it, and sending it to you. So I'm at level_photo on Twitter. Tweet this video, make sure that you're following me, and I'll pick 5 people at random. That being said, if you're an After Effects pro, go to gumroad.com/getlevel. This is where it's gonna be. You can already go there, download this stuff, but you know, watch the video, watch the tutorial so you don't have to ask me questions later. Also on gumroad.com/getlevel, a brand new Christmas overlay, and maybe more to come. Anyways, let's get right into it. So, in the actual pack, you will find one video file that is called Drone Footage by Stefano Rinaldo, because that is who shot the actual drone footage. I'm gonna show it to you a little bit later. And then you'll find the After Effects file that will be called Xmas Transition by getlevel. Don't be scared by that. It can still be used. There's nothing that really indicates that it has to do with Christmas, really. Now, once you come here, it will probably tell you that this footage is missing, the drone footage by Stefano Rinaldo. It's fine, it's in the pack. Download it. Something that you can do is right click on it and then go to replace footage, click file, and then wherever you found and then wherever you downloaded it, just find it and then click import. Boom, it will import it. Look at that. How beautiful. As usual with my custom stinger transitions, you will find the main transition composition here and then the logo composition. This will probably also tell you that something is missing or it will be empty. I don't know yet. I haven't uploaded the product yet, but this is where you will have to put your logo. This whole thing revolves around your logo. So this is what the stinger transition will look like. Without the little hiccup there. There we go. So let's break it down. The first thing that's gonna appear is that drone footage I told you about. Okay, it's wide. And then your logo will be used as an alpha channel that will, and the drone footage will appear inside of your logo. Hopefully there's a bunch of, you know, shapes, transparency, and blah, blah, blah. And then your actual logo with its actual colors will reveal and the background will disappear, leaving your logo lingering a little bit longer and then poof. Okay, this is a pretty long transition. You know, it's more than 3 seconds, it's almost 4 seconds. But the effect is pretty cool. Technically, it starts being transparent and revealing your other scene about 2 seconds and 45 frames in. This is gonna be 60 FPS. Okay, now how do you modify it? Simple, go to the logo composition. Boom, if you don't find it on top of your composition tabs here, you can just double click on here. Logo, boom, brings you here. Now, what do you do once you're here? This will probably be empty. Let me turn this on to make sure that I have transparency. This will probably be empty. All you have to do is drag and drop your logo into this and make sure that it fits. That's it. Let's find another random logo. Okay, so that's not a logo, but I'll take it. So drag and drop it into your comp. Right there is gonna show. We're gonna make sure we take up as much space into this comp as possible. Remember that it's gonna be, it's actually a little smaller, but whatever. Okay, bring it up until you can't no more. All right, and then go back to transition. We're actually gonna make this a quarter just so we can go a little faster. And then boom, and then boom, and then boom. Look at that. So your logo will work just fine. Remember, all you have to do is make sure this is clear, add whatever you want. Let me delete this, save this. Then it really doesn't matter what you put, it's gonna take into account the alpha channel, which is all the transparency. Press S to show the scale and then drag it up or drag it down until it fits and then go back to your transition. As you can see here, that works. Let me press play a little. Oh, easy, beautiful, clean, nice. All right, now how do I export it once I have this done? Maybe let's not keep the Apex one. I don't want to get sued. Yeah, let's go back to the Kappa. Again, S for scale. Blow it up. Okay, back to transition. All right, we're going to make sure this one is full. Doesn't matter, really. This is nice. This is nice. And okay, we know at the end it looks like this. How to export it? Go to composition. Okay, if I can. Go to add to render queue, or you can press Control M. Click on the output module. So right now it says lossless. We don't want that. Go to QuickTime, go to RGB plus alpha. This is the pixels plus the transparency, all right? If you don't see RGB plus alpha, make sure in format options that you have animation selected, all right? Okay, we're gonna turn off the audio output because we don't want any audio. If you want, you can add audio. I don't care. At this point, the file is yours, you know? Just don't pretend that you made it from scratch, okay? And this is called transition.mov. Click save, click render. What a beautiful man. Jeez. And then you'll hear the chimes of satisfaction. Now I'm gonna show you how to add them on OBS Studio and also Streamlabs OBS. So we're here in OBS Studio and at the bottom of our audio mixer, we'll find scene transitions. Click on it. Now we have scene transitions tab. Now click on the drop-down menu and click add stinger. That makes you add a stinger. Name it whatever you want. Click browse, go find that stinger transition that you just exported, transition.mov, click okay. Transition point is about 1 second, so let's put 1000. And we can preview the transition if we want to. Okay, 1000 seems to be a little short, so let me try 1.3. There you go. Okay, and now if I switch between scenes, there you go. You see the background fades out, and we can go back to our capture. Boom, easy clap. Now, how do you do this in Streamlabs OBS? Oh, would you look at that? That's an animated overlay that I made exclusively within Streamlabs OBS without using any
editing
software. Watch my previous video if you want to know. Okay, let's go ahead and click on top of the scenes list. We will find a little cogwheel. Why am I speaking like that? Click on it. Click on that little pencil to edit it. Make sure you select stinger. Okay. Remember that we put 1,300 milliseconds. Click browse. Go find that stinger transition that you just created, wherever you exported it. Click transition. Boom. Click done. Boom. Click done. Boom. And then click another scene. Boom. Isn't it beautiful? What is my camera doing here? Isn't it beautiful? And that's it. In a couple seconds, you have your own custom stinger transition with your logo and a little animation with some mountaintops with some snow on it. Remember, if you tweet this video, whether you tag me or not, I will find you. I will select 5 people at random and probably DM them and tell them, hey, do you have After Effects? No? Okay, send me your logo and I will send you your own stinger transition. As you probably noticed with the method that I showed for exporting it, the transition might end up being big. So if you don't have a beefy computer, you might experience a little bit of lag maybe, but something that you can do is find a way to convert it to WebM and preserve the transparency. I personally have a WebM plugin, link will be in the description. And what I do is after exporting it, I will send it to Adobe Media Encoder and just convert it. So again, it's available at gumroad.com/gallevel. There will be 3 files, the drone footage, the actual After Effects file, and then 1 free stinger transition that you can use immediately. It just won't have your logo. It will have a random shape. Make sure you read the product description before buying anything online, even if it's free. And I gotta shout out, it's your buddy Chris on Twitter. Thank you so much for retweeting my latest video and adding a little bit of kind words to it. Thank you so much. That being said, if you have any questions, leave them in the comment section below and check top right. YouTube's gonna tell you what is the best video to watch next, and underneath that you will see my most recent video. Please check him out, follow me on social media, blah 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 blah. Thank you for watching. Go out there, make me proud, get level, outie.